Hello, my internet peeps. How are you today? Welcome to my channel. This is Scott Rideshare. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So today, I want to talk a little bit about profile pictures. And this came about because, like, a couple of weeks ago, I got a request through Lyft to pick this passenger up. And as I'm driving there, I noticed his profile picture. And it was a clear headshot with a smile on his face. Big smile on his face. And I thought that that was one of the better profile pictures that are out there. When it comes to profile pictures, we're kind of like used to social media. We're used to, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. And those are social media pictures that we're putting up there for profile. It is all about personality, you know, who you are as a person. And there, I've seen a lot of great ones. I've seen some strange ones. I've seen some really cool ones. I've seen some dull ones. But when you're talking about something like Uber or Lyft, these profile photos are more for identification. So it's closer to a work ID, but it's not actually a work ID. So, like, you know, when I used to work security, there were certain things that we had to do when we took our the photos of the employees to get them on their ID badges. And there were requirements. And there were times where I would send the photo up and they'd send it back and go, this doesn't meet. You know, and I have people come in and go, oh, listen, I changed my hair. I got a haircut. Can I get a new, work photo ID? Well, it doesn't really work that way either, because some people are changing their hairstyle every week. It's basically meant to be like identification. Now, in the form of rideshare, when we're driving, you're supposed to have a picture of the driver. I know you got my picture, and you have a photo of what my car looks like, and you even have my license plate. There's plenty of people that walk up to the car. They walk to the back of the car, and I see them checking the license plate on their phone to make sure that I'm the right person before they get in. Which, you know, it makes sense, you know. Can't say no to that, but not everybody does that. In either case, there's a clear photo of my face, you know, a recent photo that I took. I've with Uber, first of all, there's almost never a profile photo. It's most of the times it's just people. It's just blank. So I don't know who I'm looking for. You know, all I could do is see somebody doing this and doing this and doing this and doing this, and guess that that's them. If there's several people doing that, it makes the guessing more difficult. I kind of have to rely on them more. It's mostly for the drivers to find the person, okay? And some people don't want their photos out there, and I get it. You know, I get it. I understand how that works. In either case, I've also seen some pretty strange ones. You know, Lyft kind of encourages more, you know, more of a photo profile, so you see more of it on Lyft than you do on Uber. But I mean, there's been times where I've seen, you know, a dog, a photo of a dog. I've seen I'm going to pick up a guy and I see a woman and child who I assume is his wife and kids. I've seen pictures of houses and cars. I've seen a sunset. I've seen all kinds of things. I've seen a guy where he's got a shirtless selfie, and I'm thinking to myself, well, okay, well, why would you post that? It's not like most of the drivers are women, and we're sitting there going, ooh, yeah. I don't understand why you do that. Now, there's a woman that I saw one time where she was laying on her stomach, and like her face was in the front, and over her shoulder, you could see her butts sticking up in the air, and she's wearing a thong. And I'm thinking to myself, all right, so all the drivers that go to pick you up, that's the photo you want them to see to identify you with, is your butt sticking up in the air. So anyway, the photos are supposed to be for identification. It's for the driver to make you, to see you, to make you out, to understand, to see who you are as he's approaching. And, you know, you don't have to make it so much like a work ID. You can make it more fun But, you know, people should be able to tell who you are. I mean, if it's a picture of your dog, we're not really going to see who you are. So anyway, I picked the guy up and he gets in the car and he was a very nice guy. The smile definitely showed his personality. First of all, I apologize. It was a morning. It was in the morning and I had the radio show going, and a morning radio show, and they had a phone prank going on. And I said to him that, you know, I could change the radio if you want. I said, right now they've got a phone prank. And he said to me, oh, no, that's fine. He goes, it sounds to me like you like to laugh and you're a fun guy. And I said, well, yeah, you know, I do like to laugh. And we're listening to the phone prank. And, you know, when the phone prank ends, you know, we kind of laughed about it. And it gets a little quiet for a second. He goes, I see you let your hair grow. The thing is, he's looking at my photograph on my profile. And it was taken when I first started with Lyft. And when I first started with Lyft, I was still working for the security company. Now, since then, I'm now full-time in rideshare. And for the first time in like 30 years, I don't have somebody telling me how to wear my hair. With the security company, I mean, pretty much every 3 weeks, I would have somebody come in, a surprise visit, and they would take a photograph of my to make sure my uniform was right, to make sure, you know, my hair was the right length, all that good stuff, and it would go on my file. and the way they kind of wanted your hair to be, it was not every security company is like this, but the company I was with, they kind of wanted a military slash police look. So it, for the most part, if it was high and tight or bald, they loved it. If it was kind of over the ears, they didn't like it. Now, in order for me to keep the kind of haircut that they wanted, I had to kind of get a haircut every 6 weeks. It can get pretty expensive, as I'm sure some of you out there know. So what I kind of did was I kind of let my hair grow out to the length where it was starting to get too long, where they were going to say something, and then I would just shave the whole thing off, and then I would let it grow out a little bit to that point, and then I would shave the whole thing off. So most people, when they saw me with the bald head or the short hair, things of that nature. And I also used to gel my hair to keep it in, you know, in place, because it does get a little curly. And you know, anyway, and because of the gel, it kept the hair dark. So since then, I wanted to see what it looked like. It's the first time in 30 years no one's telling me. So I'm just letting it grow. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with it yet. But it is kind of long in the back. It's hard to tell so much. I was thinking about putting it in a ponytail. I've never really been one of those ponytail kind of guys. But I was thinking about it because, you know, I just haven't decided what I'm going to do with it yet. So I'm just kind of letting it be, you know. In either case, I was explaining that to him, and we kind of laughed a little bit about it. And then I was telling him a story about 8 months ago. Now, understand that about 8 months ago, I had let my hair grow for about 6 months at this point. So it was shorter than it is now. And I did have gel in it on the profile picture, but at that point, when I picked this passenger up, I didn't. And there were like three people in the back, and the guy who ordered the Lyft, he wasn't sitting in the seat next to me. And we're driving, and I could see him looking at his camera, at his phone. He's looking at it, he's looking at me, and he goes, don't you think you should update your photo? And he made it sound like the photo was 10 years old. It was not 10 years old. It was maybe 6 months ago, 8 months ago at that point. But I wasn't gelling my hair. And I let it grow for like 6 months or so. To me, it looks like me. It's not like I'm 50 years older. It's just the hair looks gray and it's longer. Whereas before, it wasn't gray. It looked black because of the gel. In either case, after he did that, after he's sitting there going like this, I went ahead and I took a new photo and I tried to upload it. And they wouldn't let me upload it. I mean, it's not like Facebook where you just tap a button and you upload a new profile picture. I was trying to get it up there. Now, I'm guessing I may have to log in on a desktop and do it, but you know, it's a story. But in either case, I tried to update it on my phone and I couldn't do it. So that's the reason why I still have this photo from, it's like a year, almost a year and a half ago there. And I don't think I'm that much different where you can't recognize me. The guy was making it sound like, you know, dude, you're an old fart now. This is taken when you were in your 20s. It's not true, I swear. Anyway, we kind of laughed about it. I explained that whole aspect to him about it. And, you know, we laughed about it. The guy that had the smile, the good profile, the guy next to me, we chuckled a little bit, but it wasn't a great laugh. Anyway, I hope you liked that story. I hope you liked what I was talking about with profile pictures and some of the profile pictures that I've seen going to pick people up. And if you liked the video, give us a like. Please subscribe, share, hit that bell notification next to the subscribe button, which lets you know when you're getting new videos. Also, if you're looking to make a little bit of extra part-time money, down below, you can click one of the links. There's for Lyft and Uber. It's great part-time money. You know, you want to pay off a bill, you want to save for vacation. It's phenomenal for that. You work when you want. You flip on the app, you drive people around. You get to have funny conversations about phone pranks and the length of your hair. And then, you know, you turn the app off and you go home. You collect the money, you pay off the bill, however you want to do it. Anyway, check the links down below. I would recommend doing one at a time. You know, there's a referral bonus for each one, and it changes according to the market that you're in. I think San Francisco is $150 referral bonus for Lyft, and I think in Florida it's only $50. It depends on where you are, you know, so just take a look at it. Do one first, get that referral bonus, and then do the other one, okay? Anyway, this is Scott Rideshare. Take a look at the description down below, by the way. Like, subscribe, share. And this is Scott Rideshare. Hope you have a great day. Thank you.